Consulting me.
Oh,
I should be the last to know. Besides, with your council connections, I'd have thought you'd have heard before I would.
Yes, that is true. But you do understand, as the new chairman of the Musical Society, it is my duty to ask. You see, I want to make some plans for the future. Between you and me, I want to make a few changes. I need some hard-headed business people on that committee. Oh, to be honest, John, they're all a bit woolly. But how can I make any plans if I don't know if your activity is going to keep going or not?
I can assure you, Colin, as soon as I know, you'll know. All right?
Right, yes, of course. Thank you, John. Did you catch any of the dress rehearsal?
Yes, I did.
And what did you think?
Up to your usual standard. Of course, having a professional producer does help.
Oh, yes, she's done a wonderful job. Mind you, the principals are up tribe, you know.
Oh, I don't know. Chris has had parts in the lot as long as I've been here.
Ah, yes, but nothing as big as Petruchio. He's got a good voice, I'll bet you, but his attitude worries me. He treats it all as a bit of a joke, you know.
Well, I'm sure he'll be all right. Certainly the tickets are going very well. Saturday night's almost sold out.
Really? Oh, that's good. I've always loved Cold Party, you know. And you kissed me, Kate, to be a good one for me first year. You know, a good box office. Hello, Linda. Right and early, I see. Were you trying to miss the traffic?
No, I just couldn't settle. So I gave the children their tea and then left them with Gerald. It's awful, really, isn't it? I wish it'd be my first major role from the start and everything. I just wanted to get here, get into my part, get dressed, and get into my part, you see what I mean?
Yes, splendid, splendid. Oh, you're going to make a superb Kate, I just know it. You know, Sylvia was saying to me only the other day that she's produced this show 19 times now and she's never had a Kate like you.
Really? Well, I am feeling confident. Not that I'm not nervous, you understand, because I am. Well, my singing teacher, Norman, has been very complimentary of late.
Well, as you know, Linda, I am the chairman of the auditioning committee. Although you've had very little experience, and that some years ago, I persuaded other members of the committee it's about time we had a complete change. Not that I've got anything against Ellie, you understand, but she has been our leading lady for the past 7 years, and a very good job she's made of it too. But I felt that the public get tired of seeing the same old face year after year. It was about time we saw a fresh face. And there you were. As pretty as a picture and a voice like an angel.
Oh, Colin, how kind of you to say so. But I am aware of the responsibility placed on my shoulders, and I do hope I don't let you down.
Oh, no fear of that, my dear. You're going to be a superb gator, just know it. Oh, hello, Mark. What should I say, Lucentio? Both you look almost bright and early, eh?
I've been here since 6 o'clock.
Really? Well, I've been next door. I didn't see you there.
No, I've been in the toilet.
What? Six o'clock?
Well, on and off, if you see what I mean.
Yeah, does it, Mark? It affects me just the same way.
Does it? Oh, I thought I'd got a birthday.
Oh, dear me, this will never do. We can't have our two keenest members or the combat, as they say.
Gerald says it'll pass as soon as I say my first line.
You hope not, my dear.
Oh, Colin, you're awful.
Isn't somebody there yet?
Well, if he is, I've been struck dead.
Now, Colin, don't be unkind. I think Mark is quite fond of Sandra, aren't you, Mark?
No. Well, yes, but it's because she's such a wonderful dancer and singer. The way she linked those girls into shape is just fantastic. And she's been so patient while she helped me with the Rose Ballet.
It ain't our hot, Johnny, but don't give her that.
It's too darn hot, Pot. It's too darn hot. The number, not today's hot, Pot.
Are you sure?
Yes.
He's right, Colin. It is too darn hot.
Then where have I heard it ain't our hot? Oh, never mind. The patrons will be arriving in a minute, and I'd better be upstairs. Creates a good impression, you know. Oh, look, it's...
Really? Here, you're in the wrong dressing room. This is the girls' dressing room. That is the men's. Are you one of those who isn't quite sure? How's my fair Kate this evening?
Very well, thank you, Chris. Should I say Frid? Or should I say Petruchio?
Sexy will do, my sweet.
Oh, Chris.
Hey, how about giving me a good luck kiss before the others?
Oh, bah!
What's the matter?
I've left my beer in the car.
Hey, Mark.
Oh, hello, Sue. I've been made up.
Yes, so I see.
Is it all right?
Who did?
Neither. Is it wrong?
Well, if you're off the Rocky Horror Show, it's a bit much for Gisby Kate. Look, you've got far too much on. Get about half of it off and then use some of this brown powder. smells funny, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. You know what they say about the smell of the grease paint, don't you?
No.
Neither do I. Anyway, when you've been doing it as long as I have, the smell of the grease paint sort of gets you, even with amateurs.
How long have you been in society, Cyril?
40 years. Joined when I was 16. This is my last year. Last year should have been, but, well, with our chairman dying and Colin taking over, I thought I'll stay as chairman, stay as secretary for one more year just to see Colin settle in.
There. Is that better?
Yes, that's better. In fact, by me, Colin's... Lionel's very willing to follow you. I should learn to read. Why last year on your birthday, Mark?
Yeah, I can't wait. 6 months rehearsals, all eager for this moment. I really can't believe it's here.
Yeah, it's a funny hobby, amateur theatre. I mean, if you'd be going to woodwork classes, you'd have had a bedroom sweeper now.
Yeah, I know, but it wouldn't be so exciting, would it?
No, I suppose it would.
How many shows have you been?
You know, I do happen to know the answer to that. Colin asked me to find out, you know, for his Saturday night speech. And considering that some years we did two or even three shows, you'd never believe it, but it was 101.
Over 100 shows? Hmm? That's nearly 100 weeks. That's nearly 2 years on stage.
Yeah.
What was your first show?
You never forget the first show. It was the Vagabond King. You always remember your first show.
Why is that?
I don't know really. But that's the one that everybody remembers as something special. Perhaps it's because they remember the feeling that you're feeling now. Put on your makeup for your first part, your first show, and the paying audience, they all tune into the theatre to watch you enjoying yourself.
Oh, they won't be coming in yet, will they? I get so nervous just thinking about it.
Sit. Take some deep breaths. You know, my wife used to be just like you.
Did she?
Yeah. My Rosemary. She was in all the shows with me. Well, until last year, that is. Do you know that she was in the Vagabond King with me? Do you know the famous song that comes from that?
No.
No, you wouldn't. Anyway, it's only a rose. That's what I used to call her, Rose.
No, wasn't your first show so special? Were you both in the chorus?
Yeah, I was in the chorus and she was in the dance team. But not for long, she could sing my Rose, but and I wasn't that bad. And so the next year, we got small parts. Now, for years after that, we played the leads in things like Desert Song, Rosemary, Carousel, King and I, South Pacific.
Rosemary? That was Wynne's first show.
It was? How did you know that?
Oh, she told me only about 20 times.
Yes, he would.
You'll never believe it, but that silly old Tucker Burke would let me in backstage without my membership card. I'd have got all the way around the front. I'm so...
But you've been in once already.
I know. I forgot my beer, and I had to go back to the car park, and it is pouring down. Oh, and there's a coach just drawn up from Deptford. Everybody on it looks at least 90.
Yeah, senior citizens tonight, they're getting half price or something, don't they?
That's right. Old age, pensioners and kids. Those that can hear it can't understand it, and those that can understand it can't hear it. Right, so more serious business. Who wants a beer?
Me.
Evening, Stella. She hasn't done it. Pardon? The hymn. Read. She hasn't done it. I specifically told her after last night's dress rehearsal that it needed shortening. I mean, how am I to do another opening, another show? Shouldn't it look at my dress every other step?
Oh, dear. Can I help?
No, it's not your job. You're supposed to be the leading lady. It's Reen's job. She's wardrobe. The trouble is, if you don't catch her early enough, she's... Well, how can I put it kindly? Well, you can't. She's too drunk. There, I've said it. Oh. You may as well know she's got a drink problem.
Still, I'm sure that's not true. I've always found her very helpful.
Walton, you're of course. I'd almost persuaded him to ask her to step down when he had a heart attack and went and died. Now we're still numbered with her and our so-called chairman, Colin. Oh, he's so common, so nouveau riche.
Well, I understand Colin kindly stepped into the breach at very short notice.
He's an opportunist. He knows nothing whatsoever about the theatre. I mean, what is he? A builder with aspirations towards local politics. Pathetic. And to think a person like that should chair the audition committee.
Oh, look, I've got a card from Wynne. How nice.
Yes, you and everybody else down to the theatre cat. I mean, these are the same costumes we had when I played the lead, and that was, well, some years ago.
Well,
it's not all Reen's fault, of course. She has no control over what they send. But why do they bother to measure us? They obviously take no notice.
Well, I just hope I can emulate your performance. There
you?
My head looks slight cold. But I'll soldier on, I expect. These Harrison Howell doesn't have anything to see with.
Yes, we count our blessings, don't we, Roy?
Who's reading it yet?
No, I haven't seen it. Why?
I've got a hole in my tights.
Where? It
doesn't matter where.
Oh, yes, it
does, my boy. Ah, oh, Christ, I've got to stick that beard on
now. I grew one.
Oh, yes. You went to my last one, did you? Well, we did it last time, but old place ain't next door.
Do you mean Stella?
Yeah, Stella. Still rather you than me, mate.
Why did he get Lila to do it?
You must be joking. Pitched that one on me in the desert song when I was a rib. I look more like a wheel.
But he was willing.
Yes, he was willing.
I'll have you know, Star and I had a marvellous relationship the last time we did this show, and say it as I should. My Petruchio to her Kate was superbly matched. Of course, she never did deny hate men, right? Nevertheless.
You played House and Hell last time, didn't you, Cyril?
Yes, that's right.
The review in the Gazette said, and I quote, "You are, as usual, a well-studied, hilarious cameo."
How on earth did you know that?
Oh, Wynton showed me the report in a scrapbook.
Hey, I bet you don't know who played your part, do you?
No, I didn't say.
No, it wouldn't. He was bloody useless, the worst dancer in the world.
Who was it then?
Yours truly.
You?
And Sandy was Lois again. Mind you, she's much better this time around. She had got the experience then.
Oh, I'm sure she was good last time, but she isn't
there. Oh, well, if yes, she is, you're in for a real treat.
No, if you don't keep your head still, I'll send you the ladle to put this beard on.
Oh, no, anything but that.
It's a very comprehensive newspaper review, actually. And it said about Kate and Petruchio.
Yes, well, the past is the past. Look, we must all look forward to this show now.
Yes, never mind what. I'm sure we'll have a chance to do better next time.
Mark, why don't you go next door and find Reed, get your tights mended.
Alterations for me, so I didn't like to bother you.
Small, is she?
shouldn't worry about Sandy. She'll be all right. You just concentrate on what you're doing, Mark.
Shall I come back for my tights then?
I told you.
Things meant my tights, not Linda.
Oh, fighting over them, are they?
What?
Your tights.
Oh, don't be that. Of course not.
Evening, Arl.
Oh, Seth, are we?
Yeah. Evening, Graham. How's into the pit? Were you satisfied with them?
Oh, fine, thank you very much. It's just, well, it's the brass section I'm a little bit worried about. You know, Mrs. Wentby, French horn, she's...
Bloody useless.
But I wouldn't put it quite as strongly as that, Chris. The French horn is a notoriously difficult instrument to play.
Oh, now be super, Graham. It's a lovely score.
Yes, it is.
You know what? I couldn't see old Mark Wentby. I couldn't hear her. And I looked, but I couldn't see her.
You know, it's funny you should mention that. She's taken to wearing a red wig.
But
oh, don't laugh. It's only quite a turn, I can tell you. I didn't recognise her myself for a start. Until she began to play, of course. Oh, what's Doug and Eddie here yet?
No, not yet.
I really must have a word with those two about Brush Up Your Shakespeare. It was far too fast last night. They absolutely ran away with it. They must watch me. They can't just do as they like. I've got 18 musicians to control.
But you know those two, they won't be here yet. They're not on for ages.
Why we're on the subject, Chris? I hope you don't mind me mentioning it, but look, with respect, oh, I look at Gary's history, I might be. That's an F sharp. And you sang F natural yesterday.
Did I?
You did.
Well, bugger me, I didn't know that.
I was probably just nervous. I hope you don't mind me mentioning it, only creates a discord with the spirit.
Don't you worry, Graham. I shall watch it most carefully.
And apart from that, you're singing very well indeed, Chris.
Ah, that's what Peg Pitty does for you.
And a lot of hard work, Chris. A great deal of hard work.
Yes, you won't settle down this year, Chris. It's not going to be noticed, you know.
Yes, well, I think I'll go for a pig. That's another thing that Peg Pitty does for you.
Do you think Chris is going to be good still?
He'll be all right if he can control his nerves.
Chris, nervous? Does the tea bother at all?
Spend as much time in the loop today as you have.
He's done loads of parts before.
Ah, I know he has. He's had lots of nice in the past and he's done them very well. But it's not the same as having the responsibility of the whole show on your shoulders. It's a different thing altogether.
He's singing very well and he's working very hard indeed. In fact, I'll go so far as to say I think he's one of the best leading men we've had for years.
It's all right, Rod's not here.
Oh, you do have to be careful, don't you? Anyway, I can't stand here chatting. I'm just going around everyone, you know, wishing them luck. Oh, and Mark, do try and look at me at the corner of your eye, won't you? I know you've got your double steps to worry about, but, well, do try.
Yes, I will, Graham.
Good. It's all right, ladies, only me.
Come in, Graham.
How are we all then? All set?
Yes, thank you, Graham. Looking forward to it now. Not that I'm not nervous, you understand, because I am, but, well, you know what I mean.
Yes, I do, Linda. Now, don't take me wrong on this, will you? But I felt you were dragging it a bit in I Hate Men. Now, you must watch me closely. I have 18 musicians to control. We can't just keep changing the tempo, can we?
No, I'm sorry. It's just that my singing teacher, Norman, tends to take it just a little bit slower. He said he'd allow time for expression.
Yes, well, Norman won't be in the pit tonight, will he? So you just have to do what I tell you, won't you?
Yes, of course. I didn't mean anything by it.
No, but that's all right. Still, all the best for you. I'm sure it's going to be a wonderful show. Any problems with you on there, Stella?
Hardly. I'm not exactly overtaxed, am I?
No, not quite. Of course, I don't have to worry about you at all this year, do I, lad? Well, all the best to you all. See you later.
Oh, hello, Graham.
Hello,
hello to you, dear.
Oh, dear, come back, darling.
Take any notice about
Oh, please yourself. Harry was in the dressing room. If you did have to go to Harry Wood, then you want him to be faithful, best he doesn't be in the room. Anyway, back to business. A nice warm house today, and it's a 15-minute call. 15 minutes, everybody.
Wunderbar!
Yeah.
trying to check.
They are not overweight. And anyway, it wouldn't be any trouble to you, Stella, because it's Chris they want to meet. I told him so much about him. How good he is, I mean. So I'm sure just 10 minutes the exception could be made. Couldn't it, Sylvia?
No, I'm sorry, my dear. No, no. It contravenes all sorts of pirate insurance regulations.
Oh, dear. Still, perhaps if I have a word with John and explain the situation to him, he might waive the rules in this case.
Oh, Christ, what a bloody night I'm having.
Oh, get out of my way.
Good evening, Sandy.
Ah, just the person. What's that bloody great well doing stuff in the middle of the stage?
Now, Sandy, I did tell you about it. I know it wasn't there at dress rehearsal, but I did say it would be coming today.
You said there'd be a well, not a bloody bandstand. Anyway, I had a word from him, I told him to move it back 6 feet. And he said you'd toss it there. I'm not having it. My girl's been rehearsing for 4 months, and I'm not having it stuck beyond that bloody great thing. It'd love to go. Well, the chorus behind there, they only stand there and sing.
But it would ruin the composition.
Not the composition. Oh, Christ, Cindy, you look terrible. I put some more makeup on as far as you. She looks like you're about to puke.
Actually, I have been sick already.
She's peaked because her aerobics class are not allowed backstage on Wednesday in Mute.
Well, I'm right too. It's us this side and the enemy the other until final curtain.
Well, I still think it's worth having a little word with John.
Oh, then it was all humming and hawing, you know what they like. But I gather they're not opposed to the change.
But he didn't tell you anything concrete.
No, he's very close about it. I'll have a word with Len Jennings. He'll know if anything's going on, and he can't keep his mouth shut. Anyway, I'll keep you informed.
All right.
Hello, sounds like he talked. I'd better go off and do my duty. I'll see you later.
I'll be off and put you over in head office tomorrow. After all, I've got a staff and troll to consider.
Really? How is she? know to what he's referring.
I haven't a clue. Enjoy it.
Where's mine then?
What are you serving, you lazy sod?
Right, well, I remember that.
I enjoyed it, Mark. You do it very well.
Yeah, I'm so glad I joined. I thought it'd be a lot of old people. Well, not exactly old, but...
Yeah, you know what you mean. Don't be Cyril.
But there's a lot of young people in it this year. Nightwing's daughter and her friend.
Yes, it's hard to see some fresh young faces, and we must encourage them. Otherwise, the society will stagnate.
Terrific, everyone. Keep it going, though. It's a bit slow. Lots of pauses. Still, no doubt we'll pick up second half. And you two, can you please try and get here a bit earlier tomorrow night? Chris had to go on, not knowing whether you two were even coming. Oh, by the way, Chris, Fiona thinks you're marvellous.
Fiona?
I told you, Fiona from Watford.
Oh, yeah, I remember.
So don't forget, you two, be on time tomorrow night. You were very naughty.
Yeah, sorry, Steve. We sort of got held up, didn't we?
You've known him a long time. Yeah, we go back to my
dancer, but a good laugh.
Not as good as Margaret. Or Mark, I mean.
No, nowhere near.
I think Mark's a bit of a crush on you.
Oh, so you've noticed then, have you?
Puppy love, I suppose.
I don't mind, as long as you don't drop me on the arm.
Yes, I suppose that's one way of looking at it.
Well then, what do you think?
About what?
My good luck cards.
Oh yes, very nice to choose your wind. Thanks a lot.
Oh, it was just lovely. I don't know where you managed to find such suitable ones.
Oh, well, one of our with Southport in the summer, and I made him stop off at Stratford. Knew they'd be bound to have something there with Shakespeare on, so that's where I got them.
Really? Fancy you planning all that way in advance?
Oh, I love it. The Musical Society's my life, you know, and I just love these little touches. And of course, our Tracy's in with that art student as well. Oh, how's she getting on, Sally?
Well, I'm pretty sure what, I just wish she'd smile a little bit more. After all, this is musical comedy, not a tragedy.
Well, she worries. She does worry about getting it wrong.
Yes. Well, I worry, you worry, we all worry.
Sorry to be
a
man, boys and girls, but then I understand that the stage crew and some of these people like watching the show so much being in under a seat. We've got to show the people right and take care of the rules and make sure. Thank you, Mark. That was a half and 5 minutes left. My name's Lee Paul. My name's Dusty Smith.
Enjoy
this week.
Why not? When are you on again?
Not till the finale, boy.
Oh, that's after a little pause.
reported the paper?
No, I haven't, not yet.
It's ever so 15 minutes, everybody. I hope it sounds as good down there. We'll be in bed for well, 15 minutes.
So, Sir Good, shall I tell you what he said?
Please, Mark, yep. Do spare my blushes.
Oh, it says about Chris. He says he gave an almost faultless performance.
What do they mean, almost?
And he says he has a fine voice.
And so he does.
It says, Linda looked pretty, but was rather nervous and was saved from a potentially embarrassing moment by a quick thinking leading man. But no doubt, with little more experience, she'd become a useful member of the company. And then it says about me, it says, I showed promise.
Showed promise of what?
Well, as a dancer, I suppose.
Ah, they must have said that short-sighted reporter again. The one with the jam-jam bottom through the glass.
That's teasing him.
Go on, what else does it say?
It says, that Sandy was full of sparkle and wit, and her timing was superb. Like her, didn't it? Yeah. Says Stella sang very well, and Rod was energetic. And then it says about you, Phil. It says how many parts you've played, and that this is your last show, and as usual, you gave a highly polished performance.
Well, that was very kind of
it. It says the show was almost gone in the last moment by a hilarious rendering of Russia for Shakespeare, but a pity the orchestra was so there. The choreography was imaginative and the production slick. It's good, isn't it? Look, there's a picture opening. We opened in Venice. Yeah.
Oh, the wind's got in that front row.
That'll be one for her scrapbook.
I think I'll start a scrapbook. It'll be good to look back on when I'm old as you two. Oh, I mean.
Yeah. Here we go. Committee business. During the week of the show, I said we don't need to look at Cyril.
Well, John's been called to London, so we could know something definite about the Tivoli.
Evening, all.
Good effort, that's nice.
Yes, not bad for the first night. You've got a good right time.
Yes, I've seen it. It's just a pity they don't send someone who knows anything about music.
Or theatre.
You said it, not me. Oh, I'm Doug and Eddie here yet. I must have a word with those two. They nearly got away from me last night. They get carried away, you know. Oh, and Mark, you watch. Evening, ladies.
Rod.
All set?
Hello, Graham.
Now, Linda, you don't want any more little hiccups like last night, do you? You must watch me. Forget Norman. Just watch me. Good. Is Sandy here yet?
Yes, she is. Who wants her?
Oh, Sandy, Sandy. I thought you were excellent last night. And so were the dance team. Keep it up.
Yes, it does say some very nice things about you, Sandy.
Yes, well, it would, wouldn't it?
Why?
My mother does the crypts. Does she really?
No,
hardly seems quite fair.
No, she doesn't really. I was only joking.
Oh, look at my hair. What a mess. Karen!
I don't know what he means by energetic. It must sound like a kangaroo hopping about all over the place.
Karen! Jules was saying they usually send people who don't know anything about the theatre. He said this chap normally writes the motoring column.
Well, that's just what we were saying next door. I mean, look what he's written about the orchestra. Too loud. I mean, he says that every year. I don't know what he expects me to do. I haven't got volume control now. We'll be playing out in the car park soon.
Oh, what a good idea.
Oh, how bloody hard.
Did you call? Oh, Karen, look at my hair. Do something.
Yes, madam. Come into the next room. I've got my tongue on in there.
Can your blessings, you didn't get a bad write-up. You did look a bit of a prat up there, you know.
She thinks June's got a big mouth.
Energetic.
Oh, take no notice, Rod. He probably wouldn't think for a suitable word.
Your husband did come last night then, Linda?
Yes. He said he wanted to surprise me. But I told him that actually it wasn't a surprise at all, because everyone told me he was here. Still, I suppose it's the thought that counts.
Did he enjoy it?
Yes, I think so. Although, of course, he prefers grand opera. But he said for a provincial amateur company, we did quite well.
Praise indeed. Perhaps he'll come again tonight.
Oh, no, definitely not. He can't because the children, our babysitter, can't do Tuesdays. Actually, I thought we might go with the others tonight.
The others?
Well, you know, the gang.
What gang? Where?
Well, Doug and Nettie and Cyril and
Chris.
Yes. I think I heard them talking about a pizza. I've never eaten a pizza before. Gerald says it's all junk food, and of course, well, he's quite right. But I don't think we've heard just the ones, do you?
Oh, Stella, we now go to these after show binges, do we, Stella? They usually end up with Doug getting drunk and taking his trousers off.
Really?
Oh.
Well, I'm going.
stays in.
Oh, dear, oh dear. He's a dear one, isn't he? He does it for luck, you know.
Yes, well, he used to kiss Sandy for luck like that, too. And you know what happened there?
No, I don't, actually. I've heard rumours, of course.
Oh, well, it was a few years ago now, but at the time...
Yes?
No, it's not my place to say. I'm not one to gossip. Suffice to say, it was very unpleasant at the time. If I were you, my dear, I would steer clear of Chris offstage. He's got quite a reputation.
Oh, don't you worry about me. I'm very happily married with a wonderful husband and two beautiful children, and I can assure you I don't intend to become one of his conquests.
Well, I tell you his conquests.
It's a private conversation, really. It's got nothing to do with you.
Well, if you're talking about Chris, I just saw him trying to make another one in the wings.
Really? Who?
Oh, you know the inmates. That tall blonde girl, soprano, catches your bouquet in the finale.
Michelle Sturt.
That's the one. I just saw him getting a good look at this from her.
Well, she can't be more than 18.
Oh, you know, Chris, he looks worried about age. I give him a good look at this myself every night.
Come on. Excuse me. I must see John. I don't want my aerobics lady disappointed.
You've done it now.
See how?
Well, she thought his good luck kisses were entirely for her.
Well, doesn't she know about him and Sandy then?
Don't tell me that's on again.
Ever since about halfway through rehearsal.
Oh my God, that's been off and on for years.
Well, it's on again now with the patient.
Well, why didn't I notice then?
Bet you were too busy with your own affairs.
Deep sea diving. These are small harpoons.
I don't know how you can. I'm too nervous to think about anything else, let alone playing darts.
Yeah, I didn't think we should report in the paper last night, did you?
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, it said we nearly stole the show.
Yeah, it's good, wasn't it?
There was no nearly about it. We did steal the show.
Rush up your Shakespeare. Start quoting.
Ah, I'm glad to see you two practicing. You nearly came into it last night.
Well, you know, it's a grand mechanism. We're perfectionists.
Oh, if only that were true. Still, all the best to you all, and please, do watch. I don't want you to stick about with the good of me out, you know.
This means that you don't send that new gun.
Chris!
Oh! First, we will come through in the next 10 minutes.
And no, wait.
Tom, I'm sorry. What a friend.
There won't be so many sausages tonight. Bloody theatre cats eating some of them. And those to the left are a bit chewed up. Don't let her know. It's funny about such things. I'll get some more tomorrow. Did she say anything about them being real sausages and not stuffed tight?
Yeah, too much to worry about last night. I don't think she noticed at all.
Good. They look much better from the front.
You've got one eyebrow. It's higher than the other.
It's not.
Yeah, it is. It makes you look cock-eyed.
Oh, no. What should I do then?
No, don't worry about it. Just rub one of them off. It doesn't matter which one. And put it back on again at the same level as the other. I mean, you don't want to go around looking weird or not.
Ah! It never bothered you.
What do you mean by that? Are you casting aspersions upon my noble profile? I hope you know women have fought over this face.
Yes, it looks like it's gone a few rounds.
Right, for that, I shall flash you at 501. Loser pays for the beer.
What has committed to that time then, Cyril?
I wasn't about to timely close it down.
Well, it could be. John's been called to see his director in London tomorrow.
What are we going to do then?
Well, I'll go to the community centre, I suppose.
But they haven't got a bar.
Look, don't get worked up. It's only a rumour. There's nothing definite.
Yeah, but I mean, it won't be the same without a bar.
There's a lot of things that won't be the same. It'll take a lot of rethinking, you know, one way or another. I mean, don't rush around telling everybody, please. We don't want to spoil anybody's week.
But it's all around the society anyway. You know, rumours spread.
I know, but there's nothing definite yet, Chris.
Holly won't like it. Believe it. You really
fancies himself this week. You know, swanning around the bar in his penguin suit, playing the little bountiful, buying people drinks. Makes me sick.
Linda's husband says he only became chairman to hide his public image.
Well, he won't have much of a public image at the community centre, will he?
Well,
especially without a bar!
Well, he did hint at the last committee meeting that he'd have to reconsider his position as chairman if we were to move.
Well, you don't think he'd just pack it in, do you?
Yes, he's not doing this for the love of the theatre, you know. He's doing this for what he can get out of it.
Well, I don't know what difference it makes. They've got a really nice stage there.
Yes, I know, but they've only got 350 seats, as against 1,350. But without that extra money, there'll be no professional producer, no hiring scenery, and no hiring costumes.
And no bar!
One for Sylvia and one for Sybil's retirement present, so... you, woman.
Why are you going to wait until Saturday to tell me?
I didn't want to spoil your week.
Or yours, I suppose.
No, no, what do you mean?
You know exactly what I mean. You wanted to have your fun right up until the bitter end, didn't you?
No, darling, you know I'm not
right. You are exactly like that, don't you, darling me? Oh, I'm sick to death of playing. Oh, get out, you make me sick, you really do.
Oh, look, just calm down.
Don't patronise me. I'm sick to death of playing second fiddle to
the... Hello, what for the little lovers too? Well, you must excuse me, but I've got a costume change.
Rouse up your Shakespeare,
man who asked me to leave your class before. Ask me to ask you to leave that with my stupidly tiny state. Anyway, volunteers for the getter, as per usual, Scrob Ben, you know who you are, please call for me. Let's see the four of us, you would love me. Once again, well done, everybody.
Well, it's been quite a night for you, hasn't it, Cyril?
You could say that.
Now, has anybody seen my green tights?
Will you please be your present?
I should think they've run up on their own. Yeah, it's just what I wanted. Mind you, I felt a bit guilty accepting them under the circumstances.
What do you mean, you cheeky bugger, that I smell?
Yes, you got that under false pretences, Mr. Chairman.
Well, does he know I'm going to refuse the chairmanship? Once Colin made it obvious he was going to step down immediately.
Well, I could give anybody else to do a better job.
Oh, well, just until the AGM. Well, they will see.
Perhaps ask your chairman, sir, and he'll do something about that dreadful choice of show next year.
I don't know much about cabaret. What's it about?
Well, you know how most musicals, a boy meets girl, boy loses girl, and then boy gets girl back?
Yeah.
Well, in this one, boy meets girl, boy puts girl in the club, girl has an abortion, and then the boy buggers up!
That's a sordid little show.
It's a very good score.
And the dance singer in their underwear!
Yay! What do you think of that? I think the members should have been consulted.
Well, it was me who suggested we should do cabaret. Although if I was going to be the new chairman, and we were going to a new venue, we should have a new kind of show. Any time we'll say whether I'm right or wrong.
Good for you, Cyril.
I thought it was time we did something more modern, less traditional.
Really, you lose all the old members.
Oh, I don't see why we should. I mean, there'll be good parts in it for all ages. If they go, they go. The society's got to move with the times.
It's not box office.
What, all the dance team wearing black stockings and French knickers?
Oh, no, really? Sounds good to me.
Yeah.
Is there much dancing in it?
Yes,
there's loads. You'll be all right. And so will Sandy. I mean, Sue her down to the ground. I don't know about these other two, though.
Oh, what is the matter with you, Linda?
Oh, I can't help it. It's all over now. All that work and effort, it's all open and flesh. Oh. I shan't know what to do with myself next week.
Oh, well, there's always cabaret next year.
I don't know the stage show. I've seen the film, of course. Is there anything in it for me?
Oh, yes, as long as you're prepared to wear a bowler hat and don't wear any knickers.
Oh, I don't think Gerald would like that.
No, he'd look pretty silly and wouldn't
he? Oh, you know what I mean, Sandy.
So, still won't you? Will you still?
Well, I will.
At least it'd be something different. It gets harder every year to think of something simple to fit a waltz.
But isn't it look a little risque?
Well, depends on how it's produced. And I can't see Sylvia intentionally offending anyone, can you?
Well, still won't mean it, will you, Stella?
I haven't decided yet.
Well, you said you weren't interested in going to the community centre.
There's a good part in it for you.
Yes, there is. Quite honestly, I can't think of anyone in society who would do as well as I could.
Well, actually, I don't think I'll be with you next year. Gerald says, of course, I agree with him, that he feels the opera company would suit me better.
Oh, yes, I'm sure he's right. They're a load of snobs, aren't they?
There we are.
The opera company, Ellen, is thinking about joining them next year.
Oh, yes, you're a lovely air, Linda. They're not so common as we are.
Oh, speak for yourself, Wynne.
I've just came to thank you for the presents. Just what I wanted. Are you all going to the party?
Yeah.
I just came to show you my bath and my medal.
Oh, very nice. Oh, it's lovely, Wynne. You must be very proud.
Well, it's what we do it for, isn't it?
I know. Neither do I.
Oh, not in your principles, it's not. But for someone like me, it is. Who's always in the chorus.
Are you going to the party, Wynne?
Yes.
As if you are, haven't you better hurry and get ready?
Oh, perhaps I'd better, just to keep an eye on my Tracy. See you all there.
Bye. Oh, that crux looks dull. He's been chatting her up all week.
Well done, everybody. It's been a super week, particularly in the pit. And you've all been marvellous, faultless performances. Well, almost. Still, that's all water under the bridge now. We must look forward to next year. But of course, there's no pit at the community centre. We should be informed, you and the audience. They'll have to smarten up.
I thought the orchestra was on stage for cabaret.
That's right, it's an all-girl fan. You'll have to be in drag, Graham.
What? Is this true? I don't know the show myself.
Oh, yes, I've seen it no end of time. I've got a spare pair of red sneakers you can borrow.
No
Well, thank you very much, Linda. And if I need to get any, I'll buy my own. Now, joking apart, all those who are going to appear in the charity concert next Sunday, there's a rehearsal on Wednesday at 7:30. Now, do try to be there. It's forever such a good cause.
I'll definitely be there, Graham.
I know you will. Well done, everyone. It's been a super week, especially in the pit. And you've all been marvellous, faultless performances. Well, almost. Now, for those who are taking part in the charity concert next Sunday, there's a rehearsal on Wednesday at 7:30. Now, do try and be there. It's forever such a good cause. Now, what can I count on? What about you, Cyril?
Of course.
Oh, great. Of course. We'll be relying on you this year, boy, to do your duet with Linda.
Yeah, all right.
Now, I told you we could make it to Don Graham.
Well, that's all right.
Marvellous, Joe. Marvellous last night. I'm only sorry that this will be my last official duty with the society. I've so enjoyed my time with you, brief though it has turned out to be. But you do all understand that due to the pressure of work, it holds. I beg your pardon.
You heard. Congratulate us if you must come. Spare us the bullshit, please.
I don't know what you're talking about.
There's no prestige in it now, Mr. Coleman. You could entertain your business cronies, the local councillors in the salubrious surrounding, get quoted in the local paper, have the company name in the programme and the theatre flyer, all raising the personal and company profile. But there'll be none of that for the community centre. Come on now, admit it.
My company has put a lot of money into the society. In business, will expect return for capital outlay.
No love of the excellent point. No joy in just being part of a pleasant hobby.
Oh, I enjoy a good fast now and again, yes. To be quite candid, this sort of thing's not really my cup of tea. No, actually, I'm thinking of sponsoring the local speedway team next year, if you must know.
Oh, yes. And what about all this pressure of work?
Well, I'll go and have a word with the others. I'll see you at the party.
But not if I see you first.
Did you put a lot of the money into the society?
Well, not money really. But we used his lorries to transport the scenery, and his office used to do a lot of the admin, you know, the letters and the post and the typing and the photocopying. I mean, if we had to pay for it, it'd be very expensive.
Who's that thing?
Oh, what? I put him in there. I've been looking all over for those.
Right, you son, I'll get you for that!
Nice to see that some things don't change.
Hello, everyone. Well, another one successfully put to bed. I just popped in to thank you all very much for all your hard work during rehearsal and during the week and for this lovely birthday. And thank you, Cyril. Shall I give you a ring later in the week?
No, you'd better leave it at least 2 weeks. We've got a lot to sort out.
Don't call us. We'll call you.
Oh. And for that, Mr. Chief, I shan't read you this letter from Watford Apparatus.
Oh, go on. Please read it.
Very well. It just says what a wonderfully entertaining evening they all had, and they thought that all the principals were excellent, particularly the Petruchio.
Does it say anything about me?
No. They do thank you very much, Cyril, for showing them around this wonderful old theatre. Anyway, thanks again, and I hope to see you all again in September. Goodbye.
Bye.
Just a few minutes, if I can persuade you.
been watching tonight.
We'll get Gerald to run them home and you come to the party.
Oh, well, I'm not sure, is he?
What about you, Stella?
I don't know. I haven't decided yet. Anyway, I have to tell you.
Come with Chris and I. We're in the same car.
Yes, I noticed that. Has he been giving you a lift since Monday?
Well, you could say that. Well, I suppose you're all going to know soon enough anyway. I moved in with Chris on Wednesday. He's a dapper, but I know that we do get on really well.
Congratulations, if that's the right word. It's nice to know that someone's prepared to make a commitment.
Poor Mark will be upset.
Oh, I'm sure he'll soon get over it.
Quick, the dancers are debagging Mark off stage. They're on the right.
I told you.
Yes, was there something?
I've been thinking.
Oh, well, there's a novelty.
Look, I'm trying to be serious. You know, I play badminton at the community centre on Tuesdays. Well, as the society's moving for the community centre, Cyril says he's going to fix rehearsals there for Wednesdays, see? Well, if I change my badminton night to Wednesdays, you'll be there and so will I.
So
I thought we could meet after for a drink.
Will you get to the point?
Well, what is the point? There's no need for us to stop seeing each other after all. Except for the week of the show, maybe. And I'll head off backstage then.
And what if Madam objects to the badminton?
I put my foot down. I'm entitled to one night out a week with the boys.
Oh, you want me to have a drink with you and the boys, do you? Oh, well, that will be nice. Meet some new people. What a change.
Don't tease, Stella. You know what I mean. What do you think?
I think you've got a devious little mind.
I suppose I mean to work.
It means I'll think about it. When is your first badminton?
Next Wednesday.
Jesus Christ Superstar, then we're dark till whatever happens, happens.
So you don't know what they're going to do with the old place?
No, it just won't be a theatre or a cinema.
Have they offered you anything else?
Yes, we can go at party pool.
So you don't take it?
Well, we can pay the bills until I can find something else.
I'm ever so sorry, John. We all are.
Yes. Yes, well, I'm sorry for this lovely old theatre. They're going to leave a facade up and God knows what's going to be behind it. It's over 100 years old, you know.
Look, John, why don't you come to the party? Are you drowning in sorrows?
Go on, go to the party.
Oh,
no.
Oh, all right. If somebody can give me a lift, I can have a few.
Yes.
Steve, you can come to the edge of the van. Mind you, we've got four of the dance team in the back.
Are there seats in the back, then?
No. A mattress!
Yeah, in that top dressing room.
You know what I mean.
Yes, just the one showing you.
Well, since I've been dancing the age of 3½, I've performed everywhere, from a scout up to the Albert Hall, and I can tell you it's just as nerve wracking and just as exciting as ever.
Thank you for those words of wisdom, oh experience, won't you? Hey, do you really fancy going to this party tonight?
Why don't you?
Well, I'm a bit knackered, actually. I mean, two shows, you know, and now, of course, we've got our own bed to look forward to.
I thought you said you were too tired.
Well, I just want to make sure that I'm not.
Oh, come on. We don't have to stay long. Just put it here. Come on, let's go.
Right. You've got your stuff?
Oh, yes. I've already taken it out to the car. I came back for you, and they say women take their time.
I'm just savouring the moment.
Are you going to be available next year?
Oh, you bet! I wouldn't miss it for the world! chairman who knows what he's talking about, if you don't mind saying so. I mean, Conroy, but, well, dead Conroy, isn't he? And what about you, young man? Will we see you this year?
Oh, of course.
All the young men say that, and then you find a girlfriend, and then you don't see them again. You take my advice, boy. You stay away from women. Anyway, I can't stand here chatting. They're going to be waiting for me. Well, I'll see you all at the party in a minute, shall I?
Yeah, see you later.
All right, well, bye-bye for now.
Cyril, is Graham a bit...
Yes, he is.
Right. All right, I'm ready then. I'll see you later.
Yeah, rightio. See you later.
Bye.
Challenge.